So we're going to dive into what's new with Todoist in 2022. They've actually released a bunch of updates that I wanted to run through very quickly and overview what's new with the task management application. Now, if you're new to this channel, feel free to hit subscribe. We're just about to hit 250,000 subscribers, so it'd be great to have you here in the community for more videos where we dive into productivity tools. So Todoist have added a few new updates, and I want to start with a commenting ability, which is something which is ideal for teams if you're collaborating inside of Todoist. But what you can do now is at mention people. To be honest, I thought this feature was already there, but when notifying someone, having the at mention is a helpful function when you're working in tasks and projects to be able to collaborate together. The next big upgrade is definitely some of the new keyboard shortcuts as of January 2022. They've added 39 new keyboard shortcuts, including a real emphasis on this new command bar, which now pops up if you hit command K or control K on Windows, and it pops up in front of your screen, giving you an options to navigate to Todoist however you find fit. But you can also now interact with tasks better, allowing you to see a bit more detail and be able to move them to specific locations or edit them with more context. So it's been a huge update with Todoist. One of the bigger updates, which is a new view, but it's not necessarily a whole new experience, but filters and labels is now an option on the left-hand menu bar. Now, this definitely saves your left-hand panel from being a little bit messy. So for example, once you hit filters and labels, you can now see it from your main navigation, and you can find all of your sort of favorite filters there as well, which means on that left-hand side below, you can only see the main and core projects that really matter to you. Now, Todoist have mentioned that this super smart Apple live text integration is new, but I'm not sure it is. They released this, I think, with iOS 15, but it essentially allows you to hover over any of your text, maybe a handwritten text, and be able to insert it as task pretty instantly, which might be helpful for people who are looking to scrabble up all of their notes from a meeting that they've written on a notepad, and it can do that by inserting the text. Now, as you can imagine, Android has been winning awards for their sort of experience. They won the 2012 Material Design Award, and they've upgraded their sort of bottom bar experiences, and it's definitely a lot nicer in terms of how it looks. Now, I really neglected the look of Android, but it definitely has made some huge upgrades in the last couple of months for sure. Now, as you can imagine, they really want to sort of focus. They said that they aim for ultimate automation in 2022. IFTTT and integration map now let you connect with all of your other apps to Todoist sections and task descriptions. Now, I'm going to link to a video that actually it's not a video, it's an article that we're going to publish on our Medium that you can read all about the new features that Todoist plan on launching. And it's an interview with their CEO, Am. So hopefully you find that one interesting. You can find the link in description anyway. But this was just a short overview of some of those updates that they've released over the last couple of weeks. And they've been hitting 2022 hard. And I'm really excited to see what they're actually going to do this year in terms of sort of the hand-holding daily planner experience as that market grows. Anyway, folks, thank you very much, and make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very soon. Cheerio.